everyone, I'm Avanti Deshpande. I'm a nutritionist by profession and a nutrigenomic counselor. Welcome to my channel. So nowadays we see that a lot of the traditional bakery items are getting replaced with the healthy alternatives. So let us just check whether the healthy alternatives are truly healthy as they claim to be. So let us check the brown bread as against the white bread which is available in the market. The white bread or the traditional bread, the process of making it uses white flour or the refined wheat flour or what we call as maida as the major ingredient. As against that, when you are choosing a whole wheat bread, a part of the maida is replaced with a whole wheat. Now, what you really need to understand is when we say a part of the maida or the white flour is replaced with a whole wheat flour, how much proportion of it is replaced? Because it should be significant enough proportion so that we know or we say that the product is really, really healthy. The best way to do is to read the nutrition label. So a product which is made out of whole wheat bread especially, you check the label, and if on the label whole wheat is the first list in the ingredients written, then definitely it is a healthy bread and you can go ahead with it. But in that, if the first list in the ingredient list, if the first ingredient is still white flour or the refined wheat flour, please do not choose this bread, because this bread is nowhere close to being healthy, as maida is still the first or the prime ingredient which is used in making the bread. So now let us just talk about the second product, which the traditional biscuits, which are now replaced with the healthy alternatives, especially the high fiber biscuits. The traditional biscuits are again made out of white flour or made out of maida, but the ones which are high fiber are having an added fiber to it. Now what happens is, in the traditional biscuit, because it is made by the old recipe method, the quantity of the leavening agents will be much lesser as compared to the digestive biscuits. Because of the fiber which is added to the digestive biscuits, it requires more leavening and more fat to hold on to the formation of the biscuit as compared to the traditional biscuit. So then, when you say that I am eating a healthy biscuit which is a digestive one, as against eating any other Marie biscuit, you need to think twice, because Marie biscuit has got much lesser fat, and because you know that it is unhealthy, you might just end up eating one or two biscuits lesser as compared to digestive biscuits, which are higher on the leavening agents, higher in the fat content, and you will tend to eat more of it thinking that it is healthy. You need to make your choice yourself. Hope you will be smart enough to pick up the right kind of a bakery product next time you go to the market. Read the label, see that you're picking up the right sample, making a conscious decision, and then you can just be sure that you are going to eat healthy rather than just going by the marketing gimmicks. I hope you like the topic which we discussed today. Please subscribe to our channel, hit the like button, share it with all your family and friends. If you have any queries, you can write in to us at avanti@avantideshpande.com. You could also follow us on Instagram and on Facebook. Our handle is Nutritionist Avanti, to have the latest tips on nutrition and on health. Stay healthy, stay fit.